The gauge is designed to show a single measure value and visualize how to interpret that value. The gauge will display that measure value as a position along a range. In addition to the position of the measure value, you can define segment limit thresholds, which help put the position of the measure into context. These interim ranges can be defined with discrete color segments or transitions through continuous color gradients. You also have the ability to add reference lines in order to identify other points along the range. And, in addition to the measures, you can use expressions to calculate range limits, segments limits, and reference lines. The gauge is often used to present KPIs, for example, on an executive dashboard, and together with segmenting and color coding, it is an effective way of illustrating a performance result. It is important to set relevant maximum and minimum values to support the interpretation of the value. A gauge is easy to read and understand, and it gives an instant indication of the performance within an area. A gauge is quite space demanding in relation to the single value it visualizes. A gauge is also not always the best choice for presenting a single measure value. Problems when deciding the maximum and minimum values can indicate that some other visualization should be used. To create a gauge chart, drag and drop the gauge chart onto your sheet. Add a measure to your gauge, for example, the sum of sales. Then, in the Appearance section, under Presentations, set a range limit. You can use a fixed number or an expression. In this case, we are going to calculate 17% of the sum of sales to set the limit. Then, we are going to set Use Library to off so we can select colors for the limits. First, we click Add Limit to Separate Values, and then we color the first one in red and the second one in green. You can also display a gauge chart as bars. Drag and drop another gauge onto your sheet. In this case, we are going to add margin as a measure. Now, click Appearance and then Presentation. Then click Bar to change the gauge from radial to bar. Under Range Limits, enter the sum of sales again. Set Use Segments to On and set Use Library to Off so you can select colors for the limits. Then add three limits to the bar. The first one will be colored in red, the second one in yellow, and the third one in green. And here you have the gauge chart displayed as a bar. Drag and drop another gauge onto your sheet. Add a measure to your gauge, for example, sales. In this case, you can use a fixed number to set the range limits to your gauge. Bars can also be displayed vertically. As before, click Bar to change the gauge from radial to bar. Now, change the orientation from auto to custom, then select Vertical. As before, you can add limits to your bar and select specific colors for your limits. In this case, orange, light blue, and dark blue. If you want to use gradient colors between limits, click Gradient. You can now see your gauge chart change to gradient colors. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.